Hey guys, Future Keith here. This video turned out really, really long. It ended up being like almost an hour long. So I've cut it into two parts. So the first part, part one that you're watching right now, will be the basically unboxing and review and some of the work I had to do to the guitar after getting it out of the box. And then a demo of the stock sounds. Part two will be some of the upgrades I did to the guitar, and then a full song demo with some other players that I brought in. Cool tune that this guitar ended up inspiring, which was kind of neat. So anyway, so let's get to business. Well, hidey ho there again, boys and girls, and welcome to yet another edition of Live from the Tape Farm. Today we're going to be doing a review of a guitar, but we're going to be doing it from a slightly different perspective. There's been a little bit of controversy going on in the YouTube guitar community in relation to honest reviews. Are certain reviewers who are getting instruments from manufacturers really giving us their honest opinion, or are they shills for the man sort of thing? I will tell you personally, I think most YouTube guitar reviewers do a fantastic job, the vast majority of them. There's one guitar manufacturer that seems to, I don't know, just for whatever reason, has attracted this little bit of controversy, and that is the EART guitars, E-A-R-T guitars. Hope they're pronounced EART, because that's how I'm pronouncing it. And to be fair, there have been some YouTube channels that have addressed this very issue, and it's almost to the point now where people, and this has just been some of what I've been noticing, it's almost like people are afraid to give their honest opinion about something. Whether they received it from the manufacturer or whether they paid their own money for it, because they don't want to be seen as going too far one way or too far the other. And to a certain extent, I can appreciate that. I'm here because I really don't give a darn about any of that stuff. I'm just going to tell you what I think. And if that's cool with you, great. If that sends you into fits of hysteria, hey, you know what? That's a you problem. That's not a me problem. I went ahead and purchased with my own money, as I do with every guitar that I review. I purchased one of the EART guitars and figured we'd take a peek at it. That being said, just to kind of give you an overview of what I do and how I do it, I have never had a sponsor for a single video. Not that I wouldn't entertain one, but I don't reach out to people and say, hey, would you like to, I'm doing a video about X, would you like to sponsor that? If somebody were to reach out to me and say, hey, we've seen some of your stuff, we dig it, we think you'd like some of our stuff, I would be completely transparent and open with you guys and say, hey, these people, here's what they said, here's the way it's going to be. They're giving me this product, and I'm going to give them my honest review. And if it was anything other than that, if they said, hey, and we'd really appreciate it if you'd give us the, you send it to me, and I will take a peek at it. And if it's crap, I'm going to say it's crap. And if it's good, I'm going to say it's good. And that's it. And anything in between. So I went ahead and purchased one of the EART guitars with my own money. And just to show the complete and utter transparency of everything that we're doing, I haven't even opened the box yet. So you are going to 100% get what I get. So when we open the box, whatever's there is there. And if it's good, bad, or otherwise, you're going to see it just like I do. So let's dig in and see what we got. All right. No machetes, no swords, no chainsaws, no, just a razor blade. Here we go. Now, one thing that I've noticed is this box seems pretty tiny for a guitar being shipped all the way from wherever this says in the People's Republic of China. This did not have an outer box. It did not have it. This is it. And like I said, when it seemed a little small to me for coming all that way. So let's see what we got. Good. Get this guy out of here. So as you can see through the packaging, that we are dealing with a Strat type guitar. So normal bar and Allen wrenches. All right, yeah. Nice satin feel to the back of the neck. Thank you. Ooh, okay, so the body is kind of a satin finish too.
was not expecting that. Was expecting kind of a gloss finish, but it's very, very interesting. Okay. Wow. Okay. That's what you call a mint green pickguard. That is like hook it up with some chocolate chips and make it an ice cream mint green pickguard. And let's get close on the body here. So it is a straight up matte finish. I honestly thought this was going to be like a normal stain finish sort of thing. At least that's the way it looked on the picture on the website. But I'm digging the matte finish. And you can still see some wood grain. It's kind of hard to see, but it's there. So yeah, so just initial fit and finish. So, wow. Wow. Okay. Let's look at those fret ends right there. That, ladies and gentlemen, is exquisite. Seriously. I mean, that is really good. I am blown away by that fretwork. A little bit of a weird kind of feeling here where the rosewood or whatever this is, but it's kind of a weird kind of, you can feel the seam slightly where the rosewood meets the maple. It's just, it's weird. It's got it's different. Nothing that a Scotch-Brite couldn't fix. Nothing that, you know, just playing it for a couple of weeks probably won't fix. So truss rod adjustment down at the base of the neck, which kind of digging. I like that. The nut up at the top is just from a feel of it. Like if I was slam a hand down here to like hit an E chord, you know, I do feel I do catch my hand. You can actually hear my hand hitting that. So that's something that's going to need a little bit of work. Overall, the nut's in good shape except for like right there. Up top, I think we're good. I'm really digging the shape of these tuning keys. I don't think I've ever seen tuning keys shaped like that before. Okay, so a few surprises right off the bat. Surprise number one, it's a matte finish. In the description, it didn't say it was a matte finish. Doesn't bother me that it is. If I didn't like matte finishes, that might be a bit of a problem. But overall, I would say the only thing that's got me like, eh, right now, before I hear anything, the only thing that would make me go, ah, I need to maybe change that is that pickguard. Alrighty, let's see if we can't get the pickguard off and check underneath the hood. I'm already missing my switch tip fell off. I'm sure it's on the floor here somewhere. Yep, there it is over there. All right. Hold on 1 second here. Okay. It's underneath the fret. That's weird. So something that's happened here a couple of times already that since just working on the guitar, for whatever reason, this E string is popping off and getting caught underneath one of these frets. So, right there. It just happened again. So, while the frets look really good as far as polished and all, they are sticking up on the end to the point that the E string is pretty easily getting caught in that first fret. So, I'll have to see what's going on with that. Okay, something I just noticed while taking the pickguard off. A little bit of a paint chip, but it doesn't feel like a chip. It almost feels like it's just someplace where they missed painting, but still like the clear coat went over the top of it because it's completely flat, but it's just missing paint there, which is very odd. Let's get the pickguard off. All right, so first things first, let's just look at the routes. You could, if you wanted to, you could do two humbuckers in here. So two humbuckers in a single coil. Now it looks as though there is some sort of shielding paint, although it's not black, but it is clearly shielded to the body. So we'll check that out here with the meter in a few minutes and make sure that that is all on the up and up. Should have just taken the strings off. Looks like we do have just standard ceramic type pickups. You have the bar magnet. Now, that's not good, bad, or otherwise. That's just the nature of the manufacturer of these pickups. Some people may see that and have no problem with it. Other people may see that and just go, nope, that's a no-go. That's a deal breaker. And then, of course, you got neck, middle, bridge. Full-size pots. How good those pots are, I guess, could be debated. But they are 250K pots. Very odd-looking capacitor. And pretty standard, what I would consider generic switch. Nothing to give me concern, nor make me shout for joy. A very, what I would just consider, average interior of this guitar, which is what you would expect, right? I mean, this is a $200 guitar, $196. I mentioned earlier that it was almost as if reviewers were afraid to give their honest opinion or something along those lines. I remember when I first started doing guitar reviews, and I would review, let's say, a Firefly that cost $150. And I would point out all the good and all the bad. And invariably, I would see comments like, geez, you do nothing but complain. I'm not complaining. I'm pointing it out. I'm letting you know this is what you get. That's part of the problem, I think, with reviews and why maybe some of these things are becoming controversial is because people are afraid to give their honest opinion because they don't want people to slam them in the comments for being critical. But by the same token, they'll say nothing but good because it's almost as if that's what the people watching the videos want to hear. They only want to hear what's good. And then invariably somebody will buy the guitar and find something wrong with it and slam the person for not pointing out the something wrong. Yeah. So it's a damned if you do, damned if you don't kind of situation. So when I point out things like, you know, a very generic switch, what I would consider very standard generic type pickups, I'm not saying I'm expecting something more than that. I'm just saying that that's what it is. Your expectations, your mileage may vary. You may expect for $200 to get something other than that. I don't, but you might. And I'm not going to tell you what to expect. That's up to you. You know, you're big boys and girls. You can go down that road all by yourselves. What I'm seeing here is for $200, a fantastic beginnings of a really good guitar. Fretwork is really, really good. We'll have to figure out what's going on with this one fret down here. If it's where that E string is getting caught, if that's just something that happened or if there's an issue with the fret. From just looking at it, I don't think there's an issue with the fret. I think it's just something weird that happened. The neck itself is really, really nice. The materials are really good. Let's see. All right, is this conductive paint? Does not appear to be conductive paint. Usually conductive paint is black, you know, because it has graphite in it, and that's what's the conductive material, is the graphite. So to see the guitar grounded here would tell you, oh, it's shielding paint. And like I said, it doesn't appear to be shielding paint because I'm not seeing, you know, I'm just seeing basically the body color. But, you know, I figured I'd give it a shot. Now, this should tone out between these two, which it does, of course. As far as the body to other components, I'm not getting any sort of connectivity. So the body itself is not shielded. Now, that being said, this is really cool to have because I can slap some conductive paint on there, and now my body's all shielded, and the hardware connection is already done for me. Here's what my plan is. I mean, we're going to play it a little bit here and do some demoing of the sounds and whatnot. What I'm definitely going to do with this guitar is I'm swapping out this pickguard for sure. I don't like the green on there. I think a classic white or even an off-white, like an aged white, would look really, really sharp. And then maybe change out the pickups, but we're going to play it for a little while here and do a little demo tune before I pass judgment on the pickups. All right, so this has happened on more than just one occasion. Playing some chords, the E string is getting caught up underneath the fret wire. And it's happened more than, I would say it's happened 3 times when I've played that chord. So it's kind of interesting. And again, something we may have to figure out how to fix.
Just to kind of show you what it sounds like when that E string gets caught up underneath the fret. It's pretty interesting. Yeah, so not ideal.
All right. It has gotten to the point that every time I play a chord with any sort of authority, this is happening. There you go. Just unreal. That just should not happen. I don't care how much a guitar costs. That shouldn't happen. So the long and short of it is this. It's the gap between the fret and the fretboard. And that's where the string is getting caught, is up underneath that gap. All right, so let me show you what I've got here. That whole string getting caught thing is becoming a much larger issue than I had first anticipated. Here's the thing. It's not happening on all of them. That one's fine. That one's fine. That one's fine. That one's fine. From like the seventh fret up until we get up here. So from the 7th fret to the 13, 14, 15, 16, 17th fret, from 7th to 17th, it's fine. But anything below the 7th fret and anything above the 17th fret, it's getting caught. So I've never had a guitar where that's been an issue. These guys go on and on and on about their fretwork, about how, and there's no doubt, those frets look great. But if I can't play a string without that happening, and I just plucked that with my thumb, and there it is, stuck. So I'm gonna have to see, is this something I want to tackle and fix, or is it just something we send back? Because to be honest with you, I've never sent a guitar back, because I've always been able to fix what's wrong. I'm not sure I want to get into the fretwork on this guy. My idea is maybe some thin set super glue up underneath those frets to take up the gap and see if that helps. We'll see. Just trying to scrape away any excess super glue that might be there. You know, basically I want it in the gap, but no place else. So this is something a little weird. I noticed as I was putting the pickguard back on, the screw is just spinning. So this one here stripped out.
Well, it wasn't stripped. It's literally snapped off. I'm not sure how that happens, to be honest with you. That's something I've never seen before, but I'm going to see if I can't get this post out. It's almost like it was cross-threaded, and then it just snapped off when it was being tightened down. So I'm going to see if I can't get that out of there, and I think I have another screw that will go in there and hold it down.
Alrighty, well, no such luck. That is, like I said, I'm pretty sure it was just cross-threaded on there, and it snapped off. Luckily, I have a cheap five-way switch laying around. So I will swap it out with this guy, very similar to what's on there. And then eventually I'll order a new one just because, like I said, this one here that I happen to have is pretty, pretty cheap. But we'll put it on here just to get it going, and we'll go from there. I bought this guitar. What about all these guys who got this guitar given to them? I wonder if they had similar issues. I don't know. I mean, again, I assume positive. I assume that if they had similar issues, that they would disclose them. I don't know. Just seems kind of weird. I mean, and again, these aren't like huge, huge issues. They're very simple issues, but it's the fact that the way they have this listed is a beginner's guitar. Can you imagine a beginner getting this and having these issues? it's probably going to be pretty dang discouraging for a beginner, would be my guess. And a beginner is not going to have, you know, a five-way switch laying around. It's just, it makes me wonder, you know, everyone's saying these things are the, you know, next best thing since sliced bread. And I mean, they're good. There's a lot of really good aspects to this guitar, but switches are kind of basic. It's kind of like price of admission kind of stuff. I shouldn't have to wonder about the switch. If I were the beginner that this guitar is marketed towards, what would their experience be? Well, obviously, they're going to have to, you know, return the guitar. They may not know enough to return the guitar. All right, let's make sure I didn't screw something up. Bridge. Nothing. Nothing. Okay, bridge middle. Nothing. Good. Middle. Well, nothing. Middle. Yep. Nothing. Yep. Nothing. Yep. Middle. And bridge. I mean, and neck. Yep. And then just neck. Good. All right. So the only thing that is resolving this issue, honestly, is just good old-fashioned fretwork. As highly touted as the fretwork on these guitars claims to be, it really is no better than anything else. As far as in this price range. And to a certain extent, I'd say it's worse. At least my experience is, it's worse. Because these are stainless steel frets, which is great. But it also makes working them way, way harder. I could spend a lot more time polishing the ends like they did or getting them polished. But frankly, I just want my guitar to play. That guy right there is still catching. Hopefully that will do it. So that's going to wrap up part one of our review. I usually don't like doing two-part reviews, but there was a lot going on with this one, and I wanted to show as much as possible and to give you guys, you know, the real skinny, what's going on with these guitars. After doing the fretwork, the thing plays great. Would I recommend it to a beginning guitar player? Only if they're going to bring it to a luthier or a repair shop or something and have them give it a good once-over. And in other words, buy the guitar and then spend $50 to have somebody look it over for you and make sure that it's where it needs to be. Because once that work was done, guitar's playing great. In fact, it plays so good, the little riff that you heard ended up becoming a whole song, and I brought some other players in, and we actually recorded the song in its entirety. And I'm going to do that entire song for you in part two, as well as go over some of the upgrades I did to the guitar, getting rid of that mint green pickguard that I just didn't like, but you may like it. I didn't. I also changed out the pickups. There was nothing wrong with the pickups that were in there, but I got a good deal on some other pickups that I wanted to give a try. So part two will be more of upgrades and then
here's what this guitar can really do with a little bit of work. But for part one, we're all wrapped up. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, press outrage, hit me up in the comments below, and we'll catch you guys later.